The field of genetics has been shaped by foundational discoveries over the past century, which fought through a lack of knowledge to pioneer an understanding of the role of heritable material in human health. One such pioneering discovery occurred due to the work of Dr. Brenner, Dr. Jacobs, and Dr. Meselson, when they experimentally established the necessity of an unstable intermediate molecule responsible for directing the synthesis of proteins via attachment to a non-specific ribosome. Their paper, published in Nature Journal in May of 1961, experimentally tested the three commonly argued models of protein synthesis at the time, as well as coining the term messenger RNA. Not only did this leap in understanding pave the way for future discoveries in the field, but it answered questions that had lingered about the nature and relationship of ribosomes and DNA, as well as the function of proteins in gene expression. Acknowledgement that DNA was in fact the genetic material responsible for heritability was only accepted throughout the scientific community at the work of Hershey and Chase in 1952. They experimentally demonstrated that a virus can only infect a cell if it injects its DNA intracellularly, which put to rest the idea that protein was the genetic material. This came on the back of Avery, McLeod, and McCarthy, who published a paper in 1944 acknowledging DNA as the transforming principle in pneumococcal bacterial phenotyping, which did not receive widespread acceptance at the time. Conversely, the specific function of ribosomes remained a mystery for nearly a decade from their discovery in 1955. However, Romanian-born Dr. George Palade not only discovered ribosomes, but also shared a Nobel Prize in 1974 for unlocking the basics of their function as the molecular machinery for protein synthesis. The investigation of Brenner, Jacobs, and Meselson built upon the research of many other scientists that came before them. It is worth mentioning that another article published in the same edition of Nature Journal also addressed the existence of an unstable ribonucleic acid in E. coli. What set apart the work of Brenner, Jacobs, and Meselson was that they specifically outlined the implications of their work and delineated a viable model of protein synthesis using Escherichia coli T2 phage infected cells as a model. This model, they conjectured, may be applicable to other organisms. They observed that upon infection of an E. coli cell with a virulent phage, such as T2, the synthesis of DNA ceases immediately, yet protein synthesis continues at a constant rate. The key components of their experimental findings can be summarized as follows. 1. Upon infection, no new ribosomes were synthesized within a cell that could be detected. 2. New RNA molecules with a rapid turnover are synthesized after phage infection and has a corresponding nucleotide sequence to that of the phage DNA. Finally, protein synthesized in the infected cell occurs via the pre-existing ribosomes found native to the cell. These experimental findings expelled the then-held idea that each gene synthesized a ribosome, which in turn synthesized a protein, as well as the possibility that protein synthesis occurred directly on the DNA strand. The rejection of these widely held ideas about protein synthesis created a space where clear ideation could occur in the scientific community. The model put forth by Brenner and colleagues can be summarized into this. 1. Upon phage infection, E. coli messenger RNA is substituted for phage messenger RNA. And 2. That this substitution occurs due to a high turnover rate in messenger RNA as an unstable molecule. Therefore, the phage-infected cell is prevented from synthesizing its own protein and instead is forced to synthesize proteins from which phage particles can be formed. This model, though somewhat basic, did provide a suitable foundation for the work of Dr. Nirenberg and Dr. Matthaei, who, in 1966, cracked the four-letter genetic code. Scientists from that point on were able to decipher which amino acid sequence corresponded to each gene, and this paved the way for many modern advances, including the Human Genome Project. Modern day genetics would not be what it is today without the work of Dr. Brenner, Dr. Jacobs, and Dr. Meselson, and their contribution to the ever-expanding field of genetics.